Did you ever think that you would see a blind person driving?
Blind teenagers detecting fingerprints? Who would have ever thought?
No rain, no sleet, nor snow, no heat will stop the National Federation of the Blind Youth Slam!
We have here the largest class of scientists and engineers who are blind that will occur anywhere in the world this year. This is Youth Slam 2009.
The National Federation of the Blind Youth Slam is a summer science academy for blind and low vision students from all over the country. This year, we met at the University of Maryland in College Park, one of the largest campuses in the United States. Mike May, a blind businessman and downhill skier, spoke to the group about the week ahead.
When you're blind, if you want to navigate cafeterias or campuses or life, you have to figure out how to be adaptable. What are the workarounds? Guess what that's teaching you to be? A pioneer, an inventor. You guys have a lot of cool stuff you're going to be doing the next several days. The best thing you can take out of this week is learning those workarounds.
Students divided into tracks to learn about science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. They also attended short sessions to broaden their knowledge of these fields. Did you know that robots use non-sighted techniques to see just like blind people? They have sensors underneath them to tell their surfaces, just like canes. And they also emit sounds so that they can tell what is and what is not in front of them.
The objective of our robots test is the robot is going to move forward and using its touch sensor as well as the light sensor. When it touches something, such as the water bottles, it'll stop, back up, turn left, and continue on.
It took a while, but eventually the robots followed the course. This is so cool. What has this experience taught you this week?
This experience has taught me more about like the basic skills of programming.
Is there anything that you would like to do in the future that involves programming?
Yeah, software developing or network administrator.
At the Owen Science Center, the space track got some hands-on experience with the Skylab.
We do have the talking.
In mission control, they conducted a journey to the moon. In a short track, the students learned the constellations by touch.
The next one will be October.
We're here at Air Slam, where students have divided into teams and have been working all week long to design and build payloads which will be attached to weather balloons. These weather balloons, when released, will send information back to the radio in their classroom. The payloads also have GPS units attached to the tops so that when the balloon pops and the payload falls to the ground, they can find them.
I am psyched. I can't wait to launch these. I'm looking forward to just all the information we're going to get and when it goes up really high. Here's our parachute, and below it is tied our payload, and above the parachute, all the way up, is our balloon.
That's exactly right. It is the antenna. You were exactly right. Don't doubt yourself.
Blind and low vision mentors are an important part of the NFB Youth Slam experience.
How does it affect the students having blind mentors versus sighted ones?
We can teach them things that sighted mentors couldn't. I think even some of the sighted instructors here, who, though they might know about science, I'm noticing aren't able to teach as well as some of us blind mentors who don't even know what we're talking about, but we know how to say, touch the string in this way, feel it this way, this senses heat like this. And that gives the students a better feel for what they're doing.
Hold on tight.
Four, three, two, one.
This is Blind Design Slam. Students work in teams to build an environmentally friendly house. The only real vision you need to be an architect here is the ability to dream big.
How can we build a house using solar and wind energy that is environmentally friendly? Well, we are here at the Slam Engineers Go Green, where blind teenagers experiment to find a resource that can maintain a constant temperature. Once they find this resource, they will collaborate with the teenagers in the blind design track and build a house that goes totally green.
We have a talking multimeter that we use to measure the resistance and conductivity of the plates over there. We have solar heaters over there under the heat lamps. We are running water through a soft form of PVC piping, and we're testing different designs of solar heaters to see which one holds the most heat, and we are going to install them on the houses that the Blind Architecture Track builds.
The CSI Track investigated murder mysteries with some very unusual suspects.
Okay, I'm here with Bree, and she's from the CSI track. Bree, can you tell us the goal of the track and what you guys were doing?
The goal of the track was to analyze criminal evidence and see if we could come up with the conclusion that would be correct. Ours was the case of a slaughtered baker whom had three suspects against him, a homeless man, Matt Maurer, a rival baker, Karen Zakmini, and a friend of the baker's, Jennifer Dunham.
So who was it? Who was the slaughterer?
That would be Karen Zakmini.
Oh my gosh, I would have never guessed. She seems so nice.
Well, people aren't always what they seem.
Hi, we are here at the CSI track during a short session where blind teenagers learn to detect fingerprints. First, they were given a piece of metal with fingerprints already on them. They sprinkled on graphite using a cosmetic brush. After they wiped off the excess, they scanned the piece of metal into a computer where the computer printed out a swell form. This swell form is tactile and allows the blind teenagers to feel the fingerprints.
Hello, I'm here with Gracia Ramirez in the news track. Why exactly does Youth Slam have a news track? What's the purpose of it?
Well, I think, in my opinion, that everybody at Youth Slam thinks that a lot of different of other tracks are really, really cool. News Slam kind of goes around and documents what everyone else is doing. The finished product is a big website where you can go and either read, hear audio, or even watch the video when it's finished.
Another track developed their programming skills, building instant messaging chatbots. The students learn to think like a computer. They sorted themselves by birth date, using the same logical processes as a computer does.
Okay, my birthday is January 31st.
Slamming out the world's water crisis, where these students are trying to figure out the best ways to decontaminate water samples, keeping in mind the cost of each process.
We use the filter paper to filter out the activated charcoal along with the contaminant.
What exactly interested you in this track?
Well, I realized that the water crisis is a very serious problem in the world, and even in this country today. So I want to learn how to purify contaminated water to make the world's water supply safer.
Yes.
In this activity, we're having the students dissect sharks because we really want to help to teach them about the importance of using a non-visual technique. We want them to be able to cut safely, so we have them wear the blindfolds as a way of helping them to really concentrate on looking more with their hands and using other strategies to be safe. Most of the time, students don't get to do these kind of activities because everybody thinks it's dangerous. our hope is that by them doing this kind of an activity here, it builds their confidence. They know now that there are ways they can do things with just using a different technique.
We're here at Slam and Sports, where blind teenagers learn about kinesiology, which is the study of physical activity. Now, at the beginning of the week, they were given a pedometer, which was used to measure their steps and all their physical activity. And let's just say, these blind teenagers don't stay still for long. They took a series of tests, like flexibility tests, which were modified so they can be accessible. How far did you get on the flexibility test?
16 and a half.
16 and a half. Now, was that average or what?
No, it was above average.
Okay. Now, was this your first choice for a track or what?
No, but it's great, though.
There's a lot of blind teenagers out there who are a little apprehensive about trying out for teams like volleyball and soccer and basketball. What would you say to them?
Find blind people who've done it. Mm-hmm. I don't know the answers to everything, but I find out cool things all the time. I think there's ways to adapt things. It just takes a little creativity, thinking outside the box, and a little research.
All students got to participate in sports activities, including judo. The students took a trip to the NFB Jernigan Institute, where they tested new technology and had a talent show. On Thursday night, students had a blast at RecX. Bungee jumping, climbing the rock wall, dunking, and riding the mechanical bull.
I'm here at the Youth Slam Blind Driver Challenge, where students from the 2009 NFB Youth Slam are teaming up with undergraduates from Virginia Tech's Blind Driver Team. Students in this track are learning everything from changing the oil in a car to actually learning to drive. The car consists of many tactile and verbal cues that will help the students drive.
You're going to get instructions how to regulate the speed based on the vest.
Friday was the big day for the Blind Driver Challenge.
When you came here on Sunday, did you think that you would be driving a car?
Absolutely not.
And your right hand I'll put on the ignition, which is up here. Turn that clockwise and hold it until you hear the engine start. And let go. Perfect. You're starting. Pull your left on the brake.
It gives you freedom, and it really brings in the reality that this could happen someday.
I do like this a lot, actually. So when do you think this will, like, you can actually, like, buy this?
Man, I think that you guys are the voice. The more you guys talk about it, the sooner it's gonna be.
Well, let's get that accomplished, because this is actually pretty cool.
Yeah.
It is really safe as long as you know what you're doing and you do it right. So, I mean, it's really cool.
And we wouldn't have to rely on people to drive us places. We could just drive wherever we want, whenever we want, and leave whenever we want.
That's it. Cool. You did awesome.
The NFB Youth Slam ended with a trip to Washington, D.C. For years, people have gathered at the Lincoln Memorial to seek and celebrate freedom. So it was a natural place for us to start the Youth March for Independence. Everly Hairston, a leader in both the African American and blind civil rights movements, shared her story as a successful blind professional.
It wasn't easy, but in order for me to reach my potential, I had to keep on marching.
Welcome to Washington, D.C.
Woo!
We have come to Washington, D.C. We have come in the midst of a rainstorm and a windstorm. There are those who would not have come if they knew it was going to rain, but that didn't keep us from being here. We are going to march. We are going to take our dreams to the capital of the United States. And we're going to tell our neighbors, our friends, those in this country that we are as much a part of this society as anybody else. There are people who believe that our condition in life will defeat us. And yet, you can say to them, watch us study the kinds of science we've been talking about this week. Just watch us. We'll do it as well as anybody else. This is the meaning of the Federation. This is the meaning of Youth Slam 2009.
The National Federation of the Blind would like to thank our partners and supporters of the 2009 NFB Youth Slam. The National Aeronautics and Space Administration, the University of Maryland, the IEEE Foundation, the Motorola Foundation, Oracle, Access Computing Alliance, Maryland Space Grant Consortium, Rochester Institute of Technology, Virginia Tech University, Westminster Astronomical Society, the Whiting School of Engineering at Johns Hopkins University, You Can Do Astronomy, LLC, and our student supporters, Freedom Scientific, Maryland Space Business Roundtable, Montgomery County, Maryland, and the Space Grant Consortiums of Alabama, Alaska, the District of Columbia, Illinois, Iowa, Missouri, Nebraska, New York, North Carolina, Pennsylvania, South Dakota, Tennessee, Virginia,